Hello, my name is Lawrence and I will introduce to you our free solution for Kiosk Mode for your VR headsets when using EZ360. I will first introduce to you why it's useful to use Kiosk Mode and how you can use it. Afterwards, I will walk you through the steps to get started with Kiosk Mode yourself. After enabling Kiosk Mode, the headset will automatically start the right VR application without the need to select which VR application to start on the headset. This means that people won't accidentally open the wrong application. Also, when the application has opened, they won't be able to exit the application, so they will always watch the content that you serve them. Kiosk Mode solution that we offer is easy to use, free to install, and will simply always work. To install Kiosk Mode for your VR headsets, you will need to download the Kiosk Mode application first. We have one available for Oculus Go and one for Oculus Quest, and also this one works for Pico. After you've downloaded the application, you can unzip it somewhere on your PC. In order for the Kiosk Mode application to work on your headset, your VR headset needs to be in developer mode. We have made a separate video on how to enable develop mode for your VR headsets if they aren't in develop mode already. You can watch this video by clicking on the box right over there, or you can scroll down to the description of this video and there we will link that video as well. After you enable developer mode on your headset, you can plug it into your PC. Next step, you can open the unzipped folder and find the file named install kiosk mode. You can double click this file and a command prompt should open. Wait until the message success appears. If the command prompt won't open and you get a Microsoft safety warning, you can press more information and execute anyway to open the install file. If it is the first time that you connect this VR headset to your computer might not recognize the VR headset. You need to put on the headset and accept the permissions. After that, you can double click the install file again and wait for the success message to appear. After Kiosk Mode has been successfully installed on the headset, we need to configure it. For 360 degree videos or VR video content in general, we will need to tell the Kiosk Mode to open the EZ360 VR player as soon as the headset is booting up. For this, we need to copy a certain file in the folder that you unzipped. This file is named appforcer.config. You need to copy that file and paste it in the root folder of your VR headset device. So this is the folder that's next to the EZ360 folder. If you work with your own VR application, so a separate APK file, a VR application that you have been made by someone, and you work with EZ360, the configuration is slightly different. For this, you need to open the appforcer.config file with a text editor. In the file, you have to replace the bundle ID between the exception tags to the bundle ID of the app you have uploaded to the EZ360 content management system. So this is the bundle ID of your own app. Most of the time this is com.yourcompanyname.thename of your application. If you have multiple apps uploaded to the EZ360 portal, you can add these bundle IDs as well between the exception tags. You can add as many as you like. By making use of these exception tags, we tell the Kiosk Mode that it's allowed also for these applications to be open. So if you make use of EZ360, you can easily switch between the different apps that you pre-installed on the VR headsets. After Kiosk Mode is configured, you can restart the VR headset and unplug it from your PC. And as soon as it boots up, after 20 seconds, it will automatically open the EZ360 VR player. Also, people won't be able to get out of this application anymore, so it's ideal for public spaces. Hopefully you have a good understanding of what Kiosk Mode does and how you can set it up on your own using EZ360. If you have further questions, feel free to reach out in the comments below this video, or reach out to us at info@ez-360.com. And also make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel if you want to stay up to date to other VR related tips. Thanks for watching, see you next time.